Some of you guys may remember me from the block back in season 7 and season 9, and I'm here today to continue my creative journey and teach you guys how to create cool stuff. Hey, hey everyone, welcome back to another great tutorial. Today we're going to be going over advanced loadouts. I did go over this in my Zone Wars tutorial, but I want to go over it in more detail. I actually have a new weapon system here that I want to go ahead and show you for instant loadouts. As you remember, the old weapon system's a little buggy, and this new one is pretty sure fire to work and work well. So let's get into it. This video is a continued video on my Camp Overlook Zone Wars series. Make sure to check out the other videos in this series. This map already has the new loadout system in it, so make sure you check it out. All right, going over to my Camp Overlook map, you'll see in the back end here, I've redesigned the map using the system we're about to learn today. It's a little more complicated than the one we did in the Zone Wars tutorial, but it's going to pay off in bigger ways. You'll see here, as I start the map, the loadout's just gonna appear in my slot down there. It is not organized, unfortunately. That's the only downfall. But you don't have the weapons dropping out of the sky, and more importantly, you don't have extra weapons and empty boxes for people to go grab and get the loot they actually want, which I find kind of annoying. So these solve those things. One other thing I'd like to point out before we begin, I want to go ahead and make sure you guys set this up somewhere where no one can see it on your map. If they can see it, it will be there during the game. You can't make all of the items disappear or make them invisible, so it is good to hide them off to the side like I did in this video. The first thing we'll need for this example is a player spawn. We're gonna grab that player spawn, put it down, that way we're not flying in the air when we start the game, we're landing on the ground when we start the game. Next, we're gonna go ahead and do team inventory and settings. Now we're gonna grab that device and place it down. What are we using this device for, DirectingPete? Well, what we're using it for is to put down the consumables that we want everyone to have off the bat. That's including wood, that's including stone, that's including metal, that's light ammo, that's medium ammo, that's heavy ammo, that's shotgun shells and rockets. You can add other things as well, but you wanna put everything there like bouncers and traps that you want everyone to have before the game starts. All right, for the new kid on the block, the item granter. I have not talked about the item granter yet in any of my videos, so this is the first time we're gonna be going over the item granter. We're gonna go ahead and throw that item granter down here, and then what we're gonna do is adjust the settings accordingly. This is our new weapon system. This is where we're gonna be placing those weapons. So first you wanna go to the all options view at the top there. Make sure you put enable to game start yes, receiving players, leave it triggered players, on grant action, keep all. The rest of these options we're gonna leave alone, except for, let's keep on going here, grant condition only if space, we wanna go ahead and choose that. We're gonna keep going down here, ignoring some of these, but then we're gonna go ahead and equip granted item, the first item, because it's the first item in the slot. That's where we're gonna put our ARs. All right, moving down the list now, we're gonna go ahead and give extra ammo, no, because we already did that with the team inventory and settings. Cycle behavior, we're gonna change to wrap. Now, with all these channels, we're only gonna change one of the channels. We're gonna scroll down here, and the one we're gonna change, the most important one, is going to be cycle to random item when receiving from channel one. And I'll explain why we're doing the channel one here in just a moment. But let's go ahead and move on and duplicate this item granter now four more times for a total of 5 spawns. We wanna have 5 different spawns here because we want one for our AR, our shotgun, our SMG, our snipers, and for our consumables. All right, so we're gonna go into the first one here. All right, we're gonna go ahead and select our ARs here. In this example, I'm just gonna choose a couple. In my normal Zone Wars map, I would put a lot of thought into this. I'm gonna drop an assault rifle in here and maybe one other AR just for this example, but really think this out. I usually don't put a ton of gold weapons. I make sure I don't put any green or gray weapons either because I wanna make sure that there's a good balance. So I put a lot of purple and blue just to kind of even things out, just sneak a gold weapon there every now and again. But for these ARs, I'm just going to select, you know, that scar, purple scar, and then a blue AR. Moving on to the next one here for our pumps and for our shotguns, we're gonna go ahead and choose yet again a myriad of things here. In this, I'm gonna do the pump shotgun. We're gonna grab a tac shotgun in different variants as well, and then move along. So one thing I don't see working right now, I hope they fix it, is this area here that says equipped item, granted item two. The other one was set to first. We're gonna set this one to second because it's second for shotguns. We want shotguns to be in our second slot, right? The only issue right now is it's still not working, at least the way it seems to be explaining itself. But let's go ahead and move on to SMGs now. We're gonna go ahead and choose an SMG. Made a mistake in my last video. The submachine gun here with the fire rate, the lower fire rate is the correct SMG that was in Battle Royale. In my last video, I said it was the wrong SMG. I said it was the compact SMG, but it's actually the submachine gun. Sorry for that. But the submachine gun is the one that was recently in the game. We're gonna add some other SMGs as well into this, and we're gonna go ahead and place those in now. Going on to our next here. Before we move on though, we wanna make sure we set that to third. And then this one we're gonna set to fourth eventually, but first we're gonna set our snipers in here. So we're gonna go ahead and grab some snipers. Any ones you think will work. Once again, in my real example on the Zone Wars map, I tend to do more purple and blue and leave maybe one gold so someone gets surprised and excited. Going on to the next slot here, but once again, I seem to also be forgetting. Gotta set that one to fourth item. Don't forget that part there. Moving on to our fifth and final consumables. You can put whatever you want in here as consumables. I want to keep it simple. A med kit. I'm going to put three shield potions, so I'm going to click that three times. I want two shield potions. I want none of those. I want to do two slurp fish, or maybe one slurp fish, two floppers, and then three of the small fries. That way, we have different options for consumables. Great, and then we're going to set that to the fifth position. And once that's set, we're going to go ahead and move along. Next but not least is the device timer. We're gonna go ahead and modify the settings of the device timer. The reason we're gonna even add a device timer is there is a bug with this loadout where when the game starts, it doesn't give it to you unless you create a delay. So what we're gonna do is create a delay. We're gonna enable later on a mutator zone, which we'll go over in a minute, and then we're going to disable it as well. But first, I want you to go ahead and drop two of those timers down next to each other so we can go ahead and modify the settings. One by one. We're gonna go to the one on the left first. So we're gonna go through these step by step. Go to all options, duration 1 second, complete once, yes. We're gonna scroll it down to show trigger, no. We're gonna go ahead and keep going down here and scrolling along, and alarm audio, we're gonna go ahead and turn that one off. The volume being very loud doesn't really matter because the alarm audio is off at this point. We can leave everything else alone, but we're going to go down into the channel settings here and make sure we change one channel setting. When complete, transmit on channel 2. I'll go into this in more detail in just a moment, but go ahead and just set that up there. Now we're going to go ahead and move on to the next timer that we set up. We're going to grab another timer here, and we're going to set that one to 4 seconds. All right. We're gonna change that to complete once, yes. We're gonna go ahead and show trigger, no. We don't wanna see that trigger. We're gonna keep going down here on that listing. Alarm audio off, we don't wanna hear any annoying alarms. We're gonna scroll down here, we can leave all the settings once again alone, and then we're gonna go into those channel settings once again, but in this case, we're gonna change it again to when complete, transmit on channel 3. Sorry for the blurry image. They do not have a nice image of the mutator zone online, so I had to improvise. Guys, the next thing we're gonna do is grab a mutator zone. That's this guy right here. I've never brought this up in a tutorial before. One of my favorite new toys in Fortnite Creative. Let's go ahead and adjust these settings. We're gonna drop that mutator zone down. Allow weapon fire. Yes, we absolutely want weapon fire. We're gonna keep scrolling down here. And we're gonna choose zone width. At first I was like, maybe we should set it to a certain width, but no, we're gonna actually choose 100 for all three of these. Zone width, zone depth, and zone height. That will pretty much cover your entire map. If you create more mutator zones later, you'll go ahead and change that. Enable at game start, change that to no. Scrolling down here a little farther, enable when receiving from channel 2. So remember we set up that timer? We set that timer up to create a delay. So after 1 second, it's going to enable on channel 2, which is gonna give us our weapons. Then we're gonna change, turn to disable when receiving from channel 3. If you remember, we set a timer to channel 3 to disable. So in 4 seconds, it will go to channel 3, which will disable the mutator zone just to make sure there's no glitches or bugs. Most importantly, on player entering zone, transmit on channel 1. That's what's actually gonna put the weapons in our inventory system. Here we go, guys. We're gonna go ahead and test this out now. And you'll notice right as we load in, all of our weapons will load out. I'm a little disappointed because the weapons do not show up in any particular order. I really wish it was listening to the first, second, third, fourth, and fifth places of placement of those items, maybe in a later update, but for now you can reorganize your inventory and get it working. If you guys remember correctly from a past video, in the Zone Wars creative map video, we were using an older system, as you can see here, that was kind of clunky and it fell and it acted weird. We went ahead and changed that in this video. That pretty much sums up this video. I'm so glad you were able to stop by and hang out. We just created a massive new loadout system in our Zone Wars maps and other maps. I hope this suits you well on your journey to mastering Fortnite Creative. Until next time.